right, welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive studio. And joining me now is Dan Legault, the CEO of Antibe Therapeutics. And Dan, great to see you. How you doing?
Great to see you again, Steve. I'm doing well, all things considered.
Yeah, it is a very interesting time around the world, of course, and we wanted to check in with you guys to see how things are going as far as Antibe Therapeutics is concerned, because I know you have some really big news that's going to be coming up in the next couple of weeks. So first off, Dan, maybe you can talk a little bit about how you're handling things through the company through this pandemic crisis.
Sure. Well, for Antibe Therapeutics, we really haven't skipped a beat, although our hearts go out to the millions of companies and individuals affected around the world. Antibe's been essentially virtual for 3 or 4 years now. We have a team of about 30 people spread around North America and a few in Europe, and we've been doing Zoom meetings and using online tools for quite some time, so we really haven't skipped a beat. I mean, and Steve, a good example of that is 2 weeks ago where we did a 30-person meeting with the FDA. This was supposed to be an in-person meeting, and the FDA very nicely switched it to a phone conference. We did all of our prep on Zoom. Everyone, 14 of us around North America, did it on Zoom, and then we did our teleconference. So meeting went very well. So it's sort of an example of how we've adjusted.
Let's talk a little bit about what you guys do as a company, of course. I know you do non-addictive therapeutic treatment for pain and inflammation. So why don't you just remind everyone a bit about the company and sort of your lead drug?
Sure. So, of course, we're a publicly traded biotech. We're based in Toronto and trading primarily in the United States and in Canada. We're bringing to market a portfolio of three drugs. These are safer pain medicines. They're anti-inflammatory pain medicines, Steve. The pain market is pretty much the largest drug market in the world, and it's generally divided into two, the opioids and the anti-inflammatories. The opioids have their own problems, so do the anti-inflammatories. A huge issue for the past 50 years because they cause ulcers and bleeding in about 25% of people, but there are no good alternatives, and so the world has struggled with this. We think we've solved it. And our lead drug is nearing the end of phase two, so very exciting for us.
Yeah, so that drug is ATB-346. Let's talk a little about that, because I know that you're preparing to publish some documentation on that phase two trial in the next 3 or 4 weeks. So explain to us how big of an inflection point this is, obviously, for the company, and then sort of what may happen after that.
Sure. So indeed, we're just wrapping up our fourth and final phase two trial. It's our second very large phase 2B trial. This one is a pain effectiveness and dose ranging trial. It's actually at the current dose and two lower doses because we're relatively confident in this trial. The trial portion is actually concluded, thank goodness. So we were, as the crisis was unfolding, we were worried about that, but we have now finished that. And so we're now in the process of locking the database and analyzing the data. We're on our current guidance that we put out on February 28th for timing. It's several weeks away, short weeks away. And then we will release the primary data of this trial. A huge inflection point. The market is waiting for this. We hope and expect it will be great, because then that will launch us into what we think of as the final assault on Mount Everest.
And what will that entail?
That's primarily a three-pronged approach. We will simultaneously engage big pharma for partnering activity for the large markets of the United States, Europe, and Japan, as we finalize the design of our phase three program and discuss that again with the FDA and with the European Regulatory Agency. So those two in parallel. And we're also very much considering in the fall an uplisting onto a senior UX exchange to really unlock value for our shareholders.
Well, that's an exciting time for that, especially for your lead drug. Just while I have you here, Dan, I thought we'd update ATB-352, which is the next one that you have the next section of information out about that drug. So tell me a little bit about what ATB-352 is about.
Sure. So ATB-352 is our second drug, and it's for post-operative pain, so particularly serious pain following surgery. last year, 80% of people would have been prescribed an opioid, for example, in the United States, because the strong NSAIDs or anti-inflammatories are just too damaging for the gut. We think that we have solved that problem as well. And it's been a busy time for us. It's that drug is farther behind, but we've been doing a lot of academic work. About a month ago, we published an academic article on post-surgical models of pain. The drug performed very, very well and was very safe from a GI point of view. So we're excited by that. And just recently, the British Journal of Pharmacology has devoted its next issue, 250 pages, to the science of hydrogen sulfide. And our founder and chief science officer, John Wallace, is the guest editor of that. So he's been very, very busy, and all of that knowledge will be brought to bear on this drug as we move forward with it.
So Dan, with what's going on in the world right now with COVID-19, there is a lot of more eyes on companies like yourself, or specifically the sector in general. Are you finding that as well?
Indeed, we are, Steve. Generally speaking, of course, there are a huge number of eyes on the pharma sector, and in particular, the development sector. The development sector spans a large time frame, and albeit COVID is horrendous, it's going to be relatively short term. So companies like ourselves are not that affected by it. And so there's a lot of general eyes on it. Specifically, there are a lot of eyes on us. I think the market for a while was a bit concerned that perhaps we'd be affected by COVID with respect to our trial. Thank goodness our trial portion concluded prior to any real effects. So we have escaped that, and we're able to work remotely. One very interesting thing I would mention, and this follows along on the big thrust into hydrogen sulfide science. Ever so recently, there have been a couple of articles talking about the antiviral replication properties of hydrogen sulfide. And so we have gotten into contact with those researchers worldwide and have provided our drug ATB-346 to them to test in vitro, which means in test tubes, about this. So of course, this is very preliminary, but quite fascinating, and we feel sort of morally compelled to do this. That would be really interesting.
Yeah, that sounds very interesting. So we'll keep monitoring that situation. And Dan, I'm glad things are able to continue for you at the company and that everyone's staying safe. And thanks for sharing some time with us under these circumstances. We sure appreciate it.
Absolutely, Steve. A pleasure.
All right. Dan Legault, the CEO of Antibe Therapeutics.